Hello friends, today we will see a very simple autoencoder where we will use a sequential model of Keras, and then we will add a few layers, dense layers only, fully connected, and then we will build an autoencoder, and our aim would be to recreate the original input of MNIST handwritten dataset, which has images of dimension 28x28. So total we have 784 pixels. So first we will unroll these 28x28 and feed it to input layer. So we have 784 pixels here, which are fed to input layer of having 128 neurons. Then these are further connected to next layer with 64 neurons, and then we will start decoding it back to 128 and then 784. So this part is decoder and this part is encoder, and we will try to compare the input and output. So we can reshape it back to 28x28. And then we will plot both the input as well as our output and see that if this network is able to generate the input back or not. And this layer, as you remember, we will call it bottleneck layer, as we had seen in the previous videos. And we will compare the input and output. So let's begin in our Jupyter notebook. So first we will import the required libraries. So we will need to import a sequential model. We will just be using sequential model of Keras. And now we will import only one type of layer called dense layer, that is fully connected layer. We will not use any other layer. Later in this video series, we will see how we can use convolutional layer and other pooling layers and other to make more complex model. But in this case, we will stick to just simple sequential model having fully connected layers. And then we need NumPy. And we need the MNIST dataset. And finally, we will need matplotlib's pyplot library for plotting. And let's run it. Now we will define our model. So we will call it model, and we have a sequential model, and then we will add a few layers to it. So 128. So remember, input has 784 pixels. So the first layer it will take from the input 784 and convert it to 128 neurons. And activation we will use ReLU. And we need to pass input dimension for the first case. So this 784 comes from this 28x28 image. So we unroll it into a single vector. Another dense layer. Now this we have encoded, Now we will start decoding. So 128 and then 784. And finally we will use sigmoid activation. So now we have defined the encoder layers. So these denote encoder and this denotes decoding. And now we will compile our model. So before trying to fit the data, we need to compile the model. Binary cross entropy loss. And now we will load the data set. So we are not concerned with the Y labels because in the case of encoder, Y is same as the X, input is same as output. So we are ignoring those. We just load the train and test X values, not Y values. We will ignore those. MNIST dot load data. And then we will normalize these X and Y values. Two values between 0 and 1. So we need to divide by 255. And the same for X test. And then we will reshape it to a single dimension. So first parameter is the number of data sets. So in this case, train will have, 60,000 data sets and test will have 10,000 data sets. So we will just pick it from len function. So this is the first parameter and then multiply all the remaining dimensions. Just excluding the first one and till the end. So whatever is the dimension, multiply that and reshape it. Same for the test. And now we have reshaped it, so we will start fitting our model to these data. So we will fit the data using model.fit, xtrain and again xtrain, because y is same as x. And let's run it for 50 epochs. And let's keep the batch size as 256. And let's run it. So it has started fitting the data and it will run for 50 epochs. By the time it completes 50 epochs, let's write code for output images. So we will store all the outputs in out images and we will compare it with X test. So out images will be, once the model is trained, we will use the predict function to predict for new values. So we are, this model is fitting on the training set. We will do the predictions for the test set. So we will pass xTest. So this will do the prediction. So we can run it only after it has completed training. So let's write further for our plotting thing. So we will plot for 10 values and define the size of the figure. So first we will plot all the test, all the images from test data set in first row, and in the second row we will output the output images. So this plus 10 as compared to this will move it to next line. So if one output is here and this row has 10 outputs, then the corresponding output will be below that. For second, same thing, plus 10. So that's why plus n here. And here it should be this out images. So it's running 42nd epoch and it's almost about to complete. So now it's in the last epoch and it has completed training. Now let's predict the values. Three, two, one. Also, I have wrongly added this one. And now it has predicted the values and stored in out images. Now we will compare the test and out images. So this is the test images and these are the generated images by the autoencoder. So you can see it's able to generate the images, although we had compressed it to more than 12 times from 784 to 64 in the bottleneck layer, but still it has, the network has learned the main core components of the network. That's why it was able to generate it back. So this was a very simple implementation of autoencoder using a sequential model and just dense layers.